Story, the host of this vlog, the Yoga Ballerina Method. And today I will be demonstrating to you the technique that I used to be able to get my leg behind my head. So it's 2012 and I had been recently kicked out of yoga school and I was in search of a new practice. I needed inspiration. And I found out that Madonna was a practitioner of yoga. So I Googled Madonna yoga and what queried, yes, it was a picture of Madonna with her, oh, there's Gwendolyn, with her leg behind her head. So I tried to mimic the pose and there was no leg going behind this head whatsoever. It was astounding. I'll show you exactly what I saw when I Googled Madonna and yoga. It was one leg extended and one leg behind the head. Madonna had her hands to her heart in prayer, and it was as though she were sitting watching a television show, kind of like I'm doing now. So obviously I've been able to achieve something that was so unreachable, or so it seemed at the time. Gwendolyn, would you like to appear in the camera? Would you like to appear? Here, let's say hello. Let's say hello to the vlog. So I'm Gwendolyn. I'm the cutest baby ever. My mommy loves me so. Together at the very, very bottom. They're crossed so daintily. My dainty girl. And she's very stinky. She has an appointment with the salon for later this week. Oh, she does. My baby. Okay, I bet you she's gonna beg for a COOKIE when I put her down. Maybe she'll be a good girl and go to her bed. Look, go to your bed. The mommy put her leg behind her head. Okay, so I studied with Jody Bloomstein on Yoga Glow for many years with when I discovered Ashtanga finally in 2015. And it was through her method of practicing pigeon pose with the femur bone rotated outward rather than like inward that allowed me to open the hips. I can probably birth a child very easily, and to accomplish putting the leg behind the head. So it's the most common feedback that I get from people when I meet them on Instagram or even just anywhere where they know the kind of stuff that I can do. They're like, how do you do that? I'll never be able to put my leg behind my head. Well, I thought the same thing, kind of, sort of. But never tell me never, because I will push until I achieve my goal. And I did here. It just took me by surprise the day that it happened, but it was because of all of the hard work that I did to lead up to accomplishing the leg behind the head. And nowadays, I literally do no prep. I rarely work the opening of the hips because I'm so into my primary series of Ashtanga that I don't tap into that area like I should be doing. Maybe when I'm 40, but right now I can pop that leg back there whenever I want, and I'm grateful for that skill. So here we will just do a little work with pigeon. So come to the mat and let's take a downward facing dog. Let's do one vinyasa just to be warm. Inhale the shoulders forward over the wrist. Exhale, bend the elbows in toward the body. Inhale, upward facing dog, lift the heart. And exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, lift the left leg nice and high. Stretch through the left hamstring, point the left toes. Open the left hip, bend the knee. See the left toes under the right armpit. Then inhale, straighten the left knee, square off the hips. Exhale, draw the knee into the chin, bringing the shoulders forward over the wrist. Step the left foot through and lower the right knee to the mat.
Inhale, reach the arms nice and high, sinking the hips downward, squaring off the hips, so left hip back, right hip forward. Then we're going to take a pigeon pose. Now, in a from what I gather from my experience, from my 9 years of practicing of yoga, most instructors will have you bring the heel of the foot in toward the abdomen as you lower the hip down. So this is pigeon. This allows you to square off the hips and work the hip flexor. However, this is not a deep pigeon. In my boutique yoga days back in Swickley, we would bring our shin bone, if possible, to be parallel with the short edge of the yoga mat. And this is kind of helpful for a pose such as Galavasana, which is flying pigeon, where you do have that squared off shin with the short edge of the mat. But we're not practicing Galavasana today, even though it's a lot of fun. Today we're working to get our leg behind the head. So what I have you do here is crawl that left foot forward. Inch it forward as far as it will go without compromising the squaring off of the hips. So I can bring my left foot all the way to the center of the short edge of the mat. And I'm rotating the femur bone outward, and I'm creating what looks to be a half diamond shape with the left leg. I'm going to relax the back leg, keep the hips squaring off, and I'm going to lower the chest downward. So I'm resting my head on the foot. And as you can see, we can imagine actually lifting that foot and draping it around the neck. So this is where I stayed for a long time. I say it took about a year. I found Ashtanga Yoga on the 27th of April, 2015, and it took me about a year to get the leg behind the head. And I pushed it a little too soon. I injured myself, so you don't want to do that. You want to take this slowly, because once you achieve it, it's magical to be able to stop, drop, and put your leg behind your head. All right, so I'm leaning forward. I actually slept like this for a long time. Sure, I might have been more like sleeping with a back leg bent, or I might have been laying on my side, but I was working that hip open. And I did the same thing actually when I was 9 years old. It was 1991, and I couldn't do a formal split. So I was the ballerina who couldn't split. So what did I do? I slept like this. I slept with the leg bent, the leg straighter, the leg straighter, the leg straighter, and then eventually I was able to do a split. So little 9-year-old me was determined AF, just like I am now at 36. The body is just truly a magical instrument, and I'm so grateful for what mine can do, and I hope that I can really help you to do magical things as well. So we took pigeon with the femur bone rotating outward. Now let's come to a seated position, and we're going to bring the foot into the crook of the elbow, and we're going to press the left hand into the left knee, sit up nice and straight, and wrap the arms around the shin. Point the right toes, draw the shoulder blades back. So this is where you might be in a regular non-Ashtanga yoga class. But we're practicing Ashtanga today, so we're going to bring the foot toward the face. Again, we're creating that half diamond shape that we just created while sitting at the in pigeon pose. So you're just gonna do this. You're gonna practice this. You're going to be like this for a long time. You're gonna get that calf muscle on top of the shoulder, and you're going to have that foot at your face. So I hope you've had a good pedicure, because then you're gonna be looking at something pretty nasty otherwise. I just had a pedicure by
Pearl Aesthetic Perfecting Studio, my very good longtime friend and owner of the salon, Amanda, did a gorgeous job. She does the Russian method where she actually drills the cuticles. So I can look at pretty cuticles. I hate feet, but she makes mine as pretty as they can possibly be. Okay, so once you've been here for a couple of months, you can begin to, if it feels good, your neck feels good, get that leg back there and bring the palms to the heart. You can lean forward. You can even lay backward, and let me make sure I'm in the camera view. And actually, it might be easier for you to get the leg behind the head from being on the back first. That actually might be how I accomplished it. I can't remember for certain. But so you just draw the quadricep to the ground. And do the tuck of the shoulder under the calf muscle. Work the foot behind the head. You can straighten the leg, lower the leg, palms to the heart. And then eventually, you might be able to get both back there. Now I'm not warmed up on the right side, so it's not gonna be super pretty. Oh, maybe it is. There we go. Oh boy. And that, my friends, is how to get the leg behind the head. Work in pigeon, rotating the femur bone outward. Sleep like that, read like that, watch TV like that. And I promise, well, I don't promise you, but I'm pretty sure that you will make progress with getting that foot up to the face and then eventually draped behind the neck like a beautiful scarf by Chanel. Thank you so much for watching this episode of the Yoga Ballerina Method. It was a pleasure to work with you, and I will see you soon.